So hello everyone, my name is Navleen Kaur and in today's topic I'm going to cover context-free language under your subject theory of computation. So without any time wastage, let's start with it. So under simplification of grammar, we have already discussed the very first step, that is the reduction of CFG. And after that, the second topic that we are going to discuss today, it is the removal of unit productions. So the first thing that comes to our mind before discussing it is that what actually a unit production look like. So as you can see that in the very first line, it is mentioned that any production rule that looks like this, A goes to B, where both A and B, they are the non-terminal symbols. So that is a unit production. And now we will discuss the removal procedure. So the very first step that we are going to follow in the same line is that we have to remove this A goes to B, right? So while removing it, the very first thing that we will do is we will add an additional production of the type A goes to X, okay, to the grammar. Whenever there is a B goes to X occurs in the grammar, right? So what does it mean? So suppose you have a production that looks like this. This is the production rules we have. There is a unit production that I want to remove. And then there is a production that looks like this. B goes to A. Okay. So here it is mentioned that whenever there is a production of the form B goes to X occurs in the grammar. So here, instead of X, I am supposing that we have B goes to A, okay? So if there are these two productions available, okay? And this is the unit production that I have to remove. So I will remove it. And in place of it, I will add a new production, A goes to A. Obviously, if A goes to B and there is a production B goes to A, so obviously A also goes to A. I'm writing it here that there is A goes to B and then there is one more production B goes to A. Okay. Now we will remove it. Now if B goes to A, obviously A also goes to A because A and B both are same. So we will remove this and instead of that, we will add the production A goes to A. This is removed. This is added and this production we will keep as it is. So this is how you will remove it. Right? After adding A goes to X, right? If and only if B goes to X occurs, where X is a terminal and X can be null also. Terminal means this X can be A, B, C, small symbols. After you write it, now you can delete A goes to B. Okay? Now repeat this step one until all unit productions are removed. Suppose this is one production I have removed. Suppose there are multiple productions, unit productions. To remove them, you always have to follow the same step. Okay, let me help you with a simple example. So this example demands that we should remove all the unit productions. Okay, these are the productions available to you. And if you look at these productions carefully, so you will be able to identify that which are the unit productions. Okay, this is not a unit production at all because S goes to XY. It doesn't look like a unit production. Either this is also not a unit production because your non-terminal is approaching to a terminal. Yes, this is a unit production where one non-terminal is approaching to another non-terminal. Okay, this is again a unit production. This is again a unit production. So how many unit production? Again, this is not a unit production. You know the rule of a unit production, that a unit production is of the form A goes to B, where A is also a non-terminal and B is also a non-terminal. Okay, so I have identified how many unit productions, 1, 2, and 3, right? This is not a unit production. So there are 3 unit productions in the grammar. The same one that I identified, Y goes to Z, Z goes to M, and M goes to N. So we are done with the very first thing, that we have identified our unit productions. Okay. So at very first, we will remove M to N. It means we are starting from the last. why we are starting from the last, because after that we got this. You can start from anywhere, there is no fixed rule, but I am starting from the last. Okay, so very first, which production I am going to remove? I am going to remove M goes to N. Okay, so I am removing M goes to N. Okay, so now to remove it, what I have to do, I have to replace this M goes to N. I have to remove it, and in its place I have to add a M goes to A. Why I am adding M goes to A? Can you see here, there is this N goes to A available. Okay, if N is going to A, right, obviously M will also goes to A, because both are same. This M approaching N means that both are same. So if N is going to A here, so I can write M is also going to A. So I have removed it, and in that place I have written M goes to A. Only I can write this if there is another production N goes to A. Got it? So here it is mentioned as N goes to A. Can you see? We add M also goes to A, and then we can remove the unit production. So the production set looks like now. This is there as it is. 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 In its place, I have written M goes to A. This is again as it is. So very first unit production I have removed. So the first unit production is done. After that, we will remove the second unit production. Z goes to M. So this is the set that we got. So the same set I have here. Now I will not focus on this set. This is changed now. Why it is changed? Because this is removed. So this is the new set. So next time I am removing a new unit production, so I focus on it. Okay. So now we will remove Z goes to M. Okay. So can you see, this is the production set. This one. Just focus. So now we will remove Z goes to M. Right? So to remove Z goes to M, are you able to see that there is M goes to A? Yes, this M is going to A. So I can write Z also goes to A. So I can remove it now. Can you see here? As M goes to A, right? As M is also going to A, we can add Z also goes to A. We can add Z also goes to A. And then this Z goes to M is removed. So your production set is now S goes to XY, same. X goes to A, same. Y goes to Z, same. And B also. Now this Z goes to M is replaced by Z goes to A. Rest two are again same. Now we are left with only one production. And what is that production? Y goes to Z. This is the last unit production we have to remove. Now focus on this. Okay, we are removing this one. Now I want to remove Y goes to Z. Can you see there is a production Z goes to A? So can I remove Y goes to Z, and in that place I can write Y goes to A? Yes. So here it is the explanation. Z goes to A. So we add Y goes to A and we remove Y goes to Z. So how your production set looks like? So this is as it is. This is as it is. Now here, instead of Z, Y goes to Z, I am writing Y goes to A. And this B I have to write as it is. Right? The rest of the productions are as it is. Only this production is changed. Right? And in place of Y goes to Z, we have written Y goes to A. After that, it also goes to B. So I am keeping it as it is. So now Z, M. Now you see here, if this is the final set you got. S goes to XY. X goes to A, Y goes to A, B, Z goes to A, M goes to A, N goes to A. Okay, so if I start from here, S goes to X, Y. Okay, so if I want to draw the derivation tree, so how you can use it and do the yield? So you can replace x with a, you can replace y with a or b, but do you think that you will be able to use this z, m and n? No, these will never be used because your starting symbol is not yielding any of these. So these z, m and n are unreachable, so we can remove those. So what is the final CFG that we will get? We will get S goes to XY, X goes to A and Y goes to AB. It means after removing your unit production, you still have to think that if any production is reachable from your start symbol or from any other or not. But you can see that it is not reachable at all. You will not get the chance to use them. So you can remove them. These two you can use. So in nutshell, your unit production removal means if there is a production of the form this, then look for a production of the form this. Okay. If this production is also existing, so what you can do, you can create a new production that A also goes to A, and then you can remove this unit production because that's the purpose. We have to remove them. So this step we are following again and again. And at last we reach at this point where we found that if we use S goes to XY and later on we use the X goes to A to replace it and Y goes to A to replace it, or you can use Y goes to B. These three we will never get the chance to use. So we can remove them. Unreachable, they are unreachable. So we are left with the simplified CFG. Okay. Next is we have to, the next third phase is removal of null productions. So before removing null production, the very first step is to look at how your null productions look like. Okay. So in a CFG, if a non-terminal symbol, non-terminal means of the form capital, any capital letter. Okay. We can say that it is nullable only if it goes to epsilon. You know, this is null variable. Okay. So these type of productions, they are known as the null productions. Okay. Of the type A goes to epsilon, of the type B goes to epsilon. So any non-terminal when approaching to this null variable epsilon, it means that is your null production. And during this step, we will focus on removing such kind of productions. Okay, so the removal procedure follows like this. In the very first step, what we have to do, we have to find out all the nullable non-terminals. Obviously, these are non-terminals. I hope non-terminal and terminals are clear to you. Non-terminals means capitals. Terminals means small letters. Okay, so first of all, we have to find out nullable non-terminals, right? Which drive a terminal. Okay. Now for each production, A goes to A. If there is a production of the type, your non-terminal goes to a terminal. We have to construct productions of the type A goes to X. Okay. Where X is obtained from A, by removing one or multiple non-terminals from step one. Okay, first let's go to the example, because this step, when I will try to explain through this algorithm, it will not get that clear. But once we do the example, then you will come back and check the algorithm, so it makes more sense. Okay, so if we look at this production, so suppose in the exam also you will get a production like this, and we have what will be the target. The target will be to remove the null production out of it. Okay, so remove null production from the following context-free grammar, right? So first of all, the very first step is to identify that in this grammar, which are the null productions. Okay, so here it is mentioned that there are two nullable variables. Okay, which are the two variables that are nullable. First is A and other one is B. Okay, but if you look at the production, you will find that only B goes to epsilon. This one, B goes to epsilon. This is the only nullable variable. This is the first view that you will get when you look at this production, that okay, there is only one null production. But can you see that your A is also going to B? So if your A is also going to B and B is going to null, so don't you think that A is also going to null? So that's why it is mentioned that instead of one, there are two null productions, or instead of one, there are two nullable variables, A and B. So first of all, we are going to remove which one? The last one. We always start from the last. So the very first null production that we will remove is B goes to epsilon, this one. Okay, so how to remove it? See, this is the first step. So if you remove B goes to epsilon, the production set becomes. So this is the production set that you will get after removing B goes to epsilon. So if B goes to epsilon, okay, what it actually means? It means B can be considered nothing. B goes to null, right? Null means nothing. Okay. So if B is going to something that is null, empty. Null means empty. Okay. So if B is going to empty, it means B in itself is also empty. It is also nothing. So this is the string. This is the final productions that we got. How? Okay. So this was the main production. Can you see here? So very first production I wrote as it is. Okay. Now here your B is existing. Can you see here B is existing? So first time I'm writing B as it is. AB as it is. Okay. And this B I am also writing as it is. This is the first time I am writing it as it is. Okay. After that, can you see I have again written one more thing with this. So here I have just removed this B with, I have replaced this B with epsilon. So if I replace this B with epsilon, I am left with only A. Okay. So we have the production of the form. So this was the production. Can you see? Okay. So when I am removing B goes to epsilon. So after removing, this is the final production I got. So how I got this final production? So this is the production I have already, this one. S goes to A, S, A, A, B, and B. This is the first production that I got. So what I do, so I will write it as it is for the first time, A, B, and B. Next time in place of B, as I know that B goes to null, it means B in itself is null. So I will replace this B and I am left with only A. So this is the production that I got. First time you write it as it is. Next time you remove the B and you are left with only A. Got it? After that, this is the production. A goes to B, right? And B goes to B again. Okay, so here how I am doing. So I am writing A goes to B as it is, like this, right? And as you know that your B is also going to B, so I am replacing it with B also. And as it is going to epsilon also, I am writing epsilon also. This second step is clear or not? So this is the second one I have. A goes to B. Right? A goes to B. This is the second production I got. Okay? But can you see this B also goes to B, small b and epsilon? Okay, so what I am doing, I am writing A goes to B. Next time I am replacing this B with this B. Next time I am replacing this B with epsilon also. So this is how I got this second production, this one. After that, we are left with only this production. B goes to B and epsilon. So this will be replaced. This epsilon is not important. So I'm writing B goes to B only. After that, if we will remove this A goes to epsilon, I think it will be even more clearer to you. Okay. So after removing A goes to epsilon, this is the final production that we will get. Okay. So we have S goes to this one. I'm writing ASA, AB, B, and A. I'm writing the very first production. So see how this production is generated, this one till this one. Okay. So if you are removing A goes to epsilon, so first of all, I will write S, ASA as it is, AB as it is, B as it is, A as it is. After that, here, wherever the A is coming again, I have to replace it with an epsilon. Okay. So first of all, I have replaced this A with epsilon. So I am left with only S and A, this one. After that, here, I have replaced this A with epsilon, right side one. So I am left with AS. Next time, I am replacing both the A's with epsilon. So I am left with S. So this is a new topic. And the name of this topic is Chomsky normal form. Okay. So Chomsky normal form is also a type of grammar here. Okay. And you can check that if your context-free grammar is in Chomsky normal form or not. Okay. And if it's not in Chomsky normal form, so you have CFG with you, your context-free grammar, you have to check if it is in Chomsky normal form. If it is not, you have to convert it into. So this topic is all about that. So first of all, what is Chomsky normal form? So in Chomsky normal form, we have a restriction on the length of the right-hand side. Okay, it means the elements in the right-hand side. So if we are writing something, so this is right-hand side. If we are writing like this, so this is the right-hand side. So in the Chomsky normal form, we have a restriction on the length of the right-hand side, which is the elements in the right-hand side. Now, what is the restriction? The restriction is that on the right-hand side of your production, there should be either two non-terminals. There should be two non-terminals or a terminal. So if a grammar is in Chomsky normal form, on the right-hand side, there will be either two non-terminals like of the form this. On the right-hand side, we have two non-terminals or a terminal like this. On the right-hand side, we have only one terminal. Okay. And also, there can be a production of the type like this. Right. That your S can also goes to null. It's not compulsory that your S will always goes to null, but it can be. So these three rules it has to follow. And if it follow, then you can say that it is in the Chomsky normal form. So what are the restrictions? Restrictions means on the right hand side, there should be either two non-terminals or a terminal. Okay. Here it is mentioned that A, B and C, they are the non-terminals and A is a terminal. Let me clear it. Bye.